All right, good morning. Welcome to day nine. We're gonna get right into it. Just wanted to say this real quickly though. You know, as we read through the scriptures, I'm kind of picking some of the things that stand out to me, and we can't necessarily go through the entire chapter each and every day, verse by verse. And there's probably some things in there just for all of us that we're kind of like, what's that all about? Those are opportunities for us to ask maybe someone in a community group. If you're part of a community group, you can ask those questions, or you can ask God. I mean, it helps develop your relationship with God when you don't understand something in His Word and you go, God, show me. So that's something that's important for us to do as we walk through this chapter by chapter. So verse 2 of chapter 9, he says, they brought a paralytic lying on a bed. When Jesus saw their faith, He said to the paralytic, son, be of good cheer, your sins are forgiven. So this is an interesting little twist here. Jesus sees their faith, and this is something that we need to understand, that faith is usually visible, or we can tell when someone's in faith. They're saying what they believe and doing what they believed in. So these people believe that they brought this paralytic to Jesus, that he would be healed. And so they found a way to get him to Jesus. And Jesus was like, obviously, they wouldn't have gone to all the trouble to bring him here to me if they weren't expecting him to be healed. But he just says something that made the religious leaders upset. He goes, your sins are forgiven. And they were upset because they said, well, only God can forgive sins. And so Jesus actually literally was letting them know in kind of a roundabout way that he is God. Because he didn't back off of it. But he did do something that kind of put it in a language that they could understand. See, a lot of people in the Jewish world believe that sickness was a direct result of sin. And so Jesus, by saying, listen, your sins are forgiven you, he said, if you don't think I can forgive sins, I'm going to prove it to you by healing this man who has a disease that was produced by sin. And so he healed him. He said, your sins are forgiven. He said, rise, take up your bed and walk. And the guy got up and walked. Because it's something that's difficult for us to comprehend because we don't hear it preached a lot, but there's no difference to God between sin and sickness. He just as easily forgives sins as he does heal diseases. And for him, to heal disease is the same as forgiving sin. They're not necessarily two different things with him. I was listening to a minister talk about how they were in Africa and they were at an evangelistic meeting, and the minister was just preaching the gospel and telling them that if they came forward, God would forgive them of their sin. And so when they came forward, there were people not only getting forgiveness of sin, but there were several people who, when they got prayed for to become born again and for God to wipe away their past, at that time, they were healed of major illnesses. People's blind eyes were open, and the minister wasn't even praying for that. He wasn't even speaking to their disease. He was just praying for them to get saved, and at the same time they got saved, they got healed. Because to God, it's the same thing. And we need to get this firmly embedded in our thinking. It's just as easy for God to heal a disease, an incurable disease, a disease that any one of us have had for a lifetime, as easy it is for him to say, I forgive you. When we say, Lord, forgive me, I shouldn't have done that. For him to go, okay, you're forgiven. Same for him to say, you're healed. I don't know about you, but that excites me by Jesus saying that. So next, we're going to look at how Jesus called Matthew. He passed on from there. Verse 9 says, Matthew, he said, follow me. He was a tax collector. And I hope you've had an opportunity to watch a series that's out on DVD and on the internet called The Chosen, because we had a Bible study where we watched those and they were truly amazing. And in those particular videos or that series, it was abundantly clear the attitude that the Jewish people had towards tax collectors, because tax collectors were actually Jewish people who were working for the Roman government. and they were absolutely despised by Jewish people. They felt they were sellouts. They were traitors. The tax collectors had a lot of money, and so people felt like they got rich off of their money. They just could not stand them. And then Jesus has the audacity to say to Matthew, "Follow me." He's a tax collector. And so in the group of disciples, these guys are like, "Now we have a tax collector? How could this be?" But see, Jesus is not necessarily focused on what you do. He's looking at your heart. And it doesn't matter what you've done or what other people think of you, God sees you the way you can be, not just what you've been. And I don't know about you, but that also gets me excited, because it doesn't matter. Wherever you are, God can take you from where you are now to where he needs you to be if you'll follow him. All right, verse 18. While he spoke these things to them, he was ministering the word to them, and he said, "A ruler came. My daughter's just died," he said, "but come and lay your hands on her and she will live." And suddenly a woman who had a flow of blood for 12 years came and touched the hem of his garment. For she said to herself, "If I only may touch his garment, I will be made well." Jesus turned around, he saw her, he said, "Be of good cheer, your faith has made you well." And the woman was made well from that hour. This woman had the faith to believe that if she came to Jesus and touched him, she would be made whole, and she was. And I just want to leave you with this thought today. If her faith made her whole, your faith can make you whole. Think about it. It's exciting. All right, we'll see you tomorrow, talking about chapter 10.